young man named Wallace Dodd Ford, born on February 25, 1893, arrived in America from New Zealand at the age of 20 years old. Among his many aliases, he would be mostly known as Master Wallace Farad Muhammad. At the age of 24 years old, Farad worked as a cook in a small restaurant in Los Angeles. Within a year, he was managing the restaurant for its owner. He fell in love with a waitress, and they both moved into a small apartment together. The love affair didn't last long because of Farad's quick temper, his constant losing of money from gambling, and his drug use. On November 17, 1918, now at 26 years of age, Farad was working at a restaurant at 803 West 3rd Street when a gentleman named P.W. Gillibrand came in, ordered a meal, ate it, and then refused to pay for it. Farad lost his temper and pistol-whipped Gillibrand into a bloody mess, knocking Gillibrand to the floor as he cowered and pleaded for mercy. The attack was so savage, Farad had to be restrained by patrons.
If you ever come back in here again, I swear to God, I'll kill you.
When police arrived at the restaurant, Farad was placed under arrest. It was then that Farad admitted to the police that his real name was Wally. Farad was tried and convicted for assault with a deadly weapon. Timothy Drew, who had left the Ahmadiyya movement in 1913 under the leadership of Mufti Muhammad Sadiq, would soon be as popular as the deported Honorable Marcus Garvey. Timothy Drew, who had changed his name to Noble Drew Ali, had started his own form of black nationalism and religion. By 1928, Drew Ali's movement had set up 17 temples in the United States of America. After Farad was released from San Quentin after doing 3 years, he joined what was left of Marcus Garvey's fading movement called the United Negro Improvement Association. From there, Farad went on to join Drew Ali's Moorish Science Temple of America. And though Farad claimed to be a black African, everyone in both Garvey and Drew Ali's movements thought Farad to be of East Indian descent. His facial features, dialect, speech, mannerisms were definitely not African. The extreme transition from former drug user and pusher to black nationalist probably puzzled Farad as well as the blacks he suddenly began associating with. Many wondered what was his real motives. Wealthy Jewish philanthropist Julius Rosenwald was known for making generous donations to African Americans on a continuous basis. Rosenwald's butler was a man named Claude Green, who was a member of Noble Drew Ali's Moorish Science Temple of America, who held the title of Sheikh. Rosenwald was unaware that Green was a member of the MSTA and purchased a building for Green. Green had misled Rosenwald about his real reasons for needing such a large building. The building at 3640 Indiana Avenue in Chicago's black community was instantly converted into a mosque and headquarters for the MSTA. The building would be called Unity Hall. It was in this building that Drew Ali's financial empire would begin. From the profit of membership dues and other means, Drew Ali had amassed enough cash to live a lavish lifestyle. He married many women and divorced them whenever he desired. When he stole a woman from Green's embrace that Green had his heart set on, Green's jealousy kicked into high gear. Green now demanded that Ali give him a raise in the MSTA's financial status. Green told Ali that if he couldn't fulfill the demand, he'd become a whistleblower and expose Ali as a con man and religious fraud. Green wasn't bluffing. He possessed the organization's financial records in a safe in his own office at Unity Hall. The bovine excrement was about to hit the fan. On March 14, 1929, several of Drew Ali's enforcers stabbed and shot Green to death as he was locking up the Unity Hall building. Drew Ali, though out of town at the time of the murder, was connected to the murder of Green and placed in jail. Bogged down with his legal troubles and his organization on the verge of collapsing, Drew Ali quickly placed David Ford L. in charge. David Ford L. was one of the 58 aliases that Farrad had used. With David Ford L. now acting as head of the Chicago Mosque, Drew Ali suddenly died. A power struggle over who would become the successor of the financial empire emerged. David Ford L. had claimed that he was the man that Drew Ali appointed to the title, but many gave him the thumbs down.